Chapter 4, Vacuum Flashing. The discussion so far about distillation curves and distilling columns have treated the shape of the curves at temperatures close to 900 degrees Fahrenheit somewhat vaguely, but on purpose. There is a phenomenon that happens at these temperatures called cracking. Refiners use cracking extensively, but in controlled ways. In the distillation process, all the uncontrolled symptoms of cracking can occur. To avoid them, refiners developed vacuum flashing. Subject: a cracking phenomenon. Suppose a technician going to develop a crude distillation curve in a laboratory. Technicians do that all the time to prepare essays for use by refiners to help assess the suitability of crudes. The technician would heat the crude oil, note and record the temperature, capture the vapor and condense or liquefy, and record and accumulate the volumes of liquids. If the technician permitted the temperature of the crude to rise to about 900 degrees Fahrenheit, a sudden change in the shape less energy has to be transmitted, and the lower the temperature at which the vapor will start forming in the liquid, in other words, boil. The point is, the lower the pressure, the lower the boil temperature. Subject, vacuum flashing. Apply the pressure slash boiling relationship to the crude oil cracking problem. The straight run residue will crack as the temperature goes too high. The straight run residue needs to be separated into more cuts. The solution is to do the distillation at reduced pressure. In the vacuum flasher shown in figure 4.3, the straight run residue from the distilling unit, while it is still hot, is pumped into the flasher. The flasher is a large diameter vessel, too squat to be called a column, but that's more or less what it is. The straight run residue leaves the pump and heads down the line into the flasher, where the pressure has been lowered well below atmospheric pressure. At that low pressure, the lighter portions of the straight run residue will vaporize, but at that temperature, no cracking will take place. Various gadgets inside the flasher facilitate separating and capturing the offtake steam. As the mixed steam of vapor and liquid enter the flasher, almost all the liquid falls to the bottom. Some of the liquid forms droplets, not quite gases, but carried along with the vaporized part of the straight run residue. They start to rise with the vapor. To capture these droplets and to disperse the vapor evenly throughout the flasher, droplet mixture encounters a note distributor, a thick mesh screen or a tray of loose metal rings several inches thick. The distributor catches the droplets, which drip down to the bottom. Further up the flasher are two trays that operate the same as those in the distilling column. There will probably also be a reboiler, though it's not shown in the figure. Reflux, serving the same purpose as it does in the distilling column, is in the same form of a liquid spray from the top of the vessel, using some of the cooled streams drawn off one of the trays. The note vacuum pump at the top of the vessel maintains the low pressure in the vessel and continuously draws off any vapors that have not condensed and usually consist of small amounts of water. Some vacuum flashers use a device called a steam and eductor to maintain the low pressure. Two streams drawn off the upper part of the flasher. Note, light flash distillate. And note, heavy flash distillate. Together are called, note, flasher distillate. designers to help assess the suitability of thrift. The technicians will heat the crude oil, note and record the temperature, capture the vapor and condense for liquid thrift, and record and accumulate the molecules. If the technician prevents the temperature of the crude to rise to about 900 degrees Fahrenheit, a sudden change in the shape of the distillation curve will take place. As the temperature went from 900 to 1000 degrees Fahrenheit, the cumulative volume would recover, would exceed 100%, and crude would still be boiling in the pot. This might exaggerate what anyone can molecules, they have not yet vaporized at 900 degrees Fahrenheit, are heated to a higher temperature. The energy transfer from the heat is enough to cause the molecules to crack to two or more smaller molecules. For example, in figure 4.1, a molecule of carbon 16, hydrogen 34 may crack into three pieces, carbon 8, hydrogen 18, carbon 6, carbon 2, hydrogen 4. A fuller discussion of the chemical reaction of cracking will be covered in the chapter on cat cracking. If you recall the discussion on boiling points, it starts to become apparent why the shape of the distillation curve behaves so strangely at this point. The smaller molecules boil at much lower temperature than the larger ones. As cracking creates them, they leap out of the crude oil. That tells only half the story. Why does more volume get created so that the distillation curve exceeds 100%? In simple terms, the smaller molecules take up more room than the larger ones. Again, recall the discussion on hydrocarbon properties and specific gravities. The compound C16H34 weighs 7.2 pounds per gallon, and C8H18, C6H12, and C2H4 weigh 5.9, 5.6, and 3.1 respectively. Take a gallon of C16H34 and suppose you could crack it completely into these three compounds. It never happens that way. Combinations of different compounds turn up two. The chemistry of it says that there would be 50% C6H18, 30% C6H12, and 12% C2H4. The percentages are by weight, not by volume. Figure 4.2. To make the calculation easy, start with 7.2 pounds of C6H34 and calculate the change as follows. Note the calculations on the top of page 41. Cracking is a lucrative process only when it is controlled. The distilling unit is not designed to control it, so refiners avoid it by not raising the temperatures in the distilling process. The heaviest cut point on a distilling column is around 750 degrees Fahrenheit. There are, nonetheless, lots of hydrocarbons that need to be separated from the straight lead residue, and a technique used is vacuum flashing. Subject: effects of low pressure. Suppose you own a chain of restaurants that specializes in serving.
Temperature volume relationship, as if the theoretical distillation took place.
they assume the vacuum flasher is part of the distillation.
Thank you.
there are nonetheless lots of hydrocarbons in each of the separate stir run residue, and the technique used is vacuum flashing. Subject, effects of low pressure. Suppose you own a chain of restaurants that specialize in serving stuffed baked potatoes, one in Houston, Texas, one in Denver, Colorado. Do you know that baking potatoes in Denver takes 20 minutes?
Heavy.
calculation easy. Start with 7.2 pounds of C6H34 and calculate the change as follows. Note the calculations on the top of page 41. Cracking is a lucrative process only when it is controlled. The distilling unit is not designed to control it, so refiners avoid it by not raising the temperatures in the distilling process. The heaviest cut point on a distilling column is around 750 degrees Fahrenheit. There are, nonetheless, lots of hydrocarbons in use that would be a straight run residue, and the technique used is vacuum flashing. Subject. Thank you. machines or used by refiners to help assess the suitability of crude. The technician would need the material, note and record the temperature, capture the vapor and components or liquid bodies, and record and accumulate the volumes of liquids. If the technician permitted the temperature of the machine to rise to about 900 degrees Fahrenheit, a sudden change in the shape of the distillation as the temperature went from 900 to 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit, the cumulative volume would recover would exceed 100%, and crude would still be boiling in the pot. This might exaggerate what anyone can even observe with the naked eye, but it makes the point. As the complicated hydrocarbon molecules, they have not yet vaporized at 900 degrees Fahrenheit, are heated to a higher temperature. The energy transfer from the heat is enough to cause the molecules to crack into two or more smaller molecules. For example, in figure 4.1, a molecule of carbon 16, hydrogen 34 may crack into three pieces: carbon 8, hydrogen 18, carbon 6, hydrogen 12, and carbon 2, hydrogen 4. A fuller discussion of the chemical reaction of cracking will be covered in the chapter on cat cracking. If you recall the discussion on boiling points, it starts to become apparent why the shape of the distillation curve behaves so strangely at this point. The smaller molecules boil at much lower temperatures than the larger ones. As cracking creates them, they leak out of the crude oil. That tells only half the story. Why does more volume get created so that the distillation curve exceeds 100%? In simple terms, the smaller molecules take up more room than the larger ones. Again, recall the discussion on hydrocarbon properties and specific gravities. The compound C16H34 weighs 7.2 pounds per gallon. Not raising the temperatures in the distilling process. The heaviest cut point on this flashing.